In our previous video, we had begun our second poem, An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum, and we had discussed the first stanza in which the poet describes the diseased condition, the pathetic and miserable condition of the slum children, right? And in likewise, in the second stanza, what the poet has discussed? The poet has discussed the distorted classroom and its contents. जो second stanza है उसमें poet जो है वो क्या discuss कर रहा है? Distorted means the decayed condition of the classroom and its contents, right? So in the first line we see that on sour cream walls donations Shakespeare's had cloudless at its dawn civilized dome riding old cities belled flowery tireless valley, right? So in this stanza the poet is discussing that he is highlighting the things. What he says? He says that the walls of the school has grown sore. It means they have lost their freshness. It has grown the walls has grown off white, right? And it may be due to unrepaired condition, right? And then there are donations on the wall, donations, right? The rich people who might have donated the things to as a work of charity, right? And what they have donated? They have donated Shakespeare's head. They have donated a portrait of Shakespeare. Here Shakespeare is the symbol of literate world outside. It means that Shakespeare is the symbol of an educated a refined world outside, right? And what else are there? There are the pictures of cloudless at dawn. There is a picture of a very clear pollution free sky, right? It means a beautiful morning. A picture of a beautiful morning is also there on the wall. And then there is a picture of civilized domes riding old cities. These things represent the progressive world, or you can say these things represent the progress of human civilization, right? And then there is a picture of bells are the symbol of you can say it's a symbol of religion or purity or something that is very pious, right? And then there is a beautiful picture of a tireless valley which represent beautiful and fresh nature, right? So these are the things which are displayed there on the walls of slum classroom, right? And then the poet says that then there is an open-handed map. Then there is a map, there is a picture of map also that is there on the wall. And what he says, open-handed map awarding the world its world, right? It means the map that is displayed there on the wall of the classroom, it belongs to the people who are different from these children, yeah? Or you can say that it belongs to the world that is different from the world of these children who are there in the slum classroom, right? And where is the world of those children? How the world is different how is the world different from the rest of the world? Yes, what he says, and yet for these children, these windows, not this world, their world, right? What he says, you can say that the map there gives a glimpse of beautiful world, but this world map does not belong to the children who are sitting over there in the slum classroom. And where is their world? Their world is outside these windows. These windows means the windows of the slum classroom. And what is there? Their world where all their future painted with fog. Yes. And outside the window of the slum classroom, one can see their future. Actually, they can't see because it is foggy and uncertain. They have uncertain, and you can say they have bleak future, right? A narrow street, and then the living areas are narrow. They don't have very spacious area or spacious place to live in. Their streets are narrow, which are sealed in with the lead sky. Yes, and the whole environment there is very polluted, right? And their lives are far away from the rivers and caves. Here rivers and caves describes the adventure and enjoyment of nature, right? But the lives of these children, the children of slum, is very far away from all kind of adventure or all kind of enjoyment that is present over there in nature, right? And also they are away from the stars of world. They are very far away from all kind of wisdom, or you can say education, right? So in this paragraph, in this stanza, the poet describes the distorted condition of classroom and its contents, and what has been displayed over there. What is displayed over there? The you can say the different portraits, or you can say wall hangings, or you can say some pictures are displayed over there, which were actually donated by some of the rich people out of charity, right? So that's all about this explanation. Now let us see some literary devices used in this stanza. First of all, we can say that there is pun in this line, sour cream. And how you can explain the pun over there? Sour cream, its literal meaning is, what is the literal meaning over here? Literal meaning kya hai iska? Ki these are neglected walls. These are not repaired properly. That's why they have grown off-white, right? And what is the figurative meaning? Figurative meaning kya hai? It means it is the dismal place where all the dreams turn sour, right? ये एक ऐसा dismal place है, ऐसा gloomy और dismal place है जहाँ पर सारे dreams जो हैं वो हो जाते हैं sour. They don't turn out to be real, right? And then here we also have a pun, lead sky. Lead sky का literal meaning क्या है? Polluted sky, polluted environment, right? और इसका figurative meaning क्या है? That it does not open opportunities for these children. It limited their lives, right? And now let us discuss some metaphors over there. जो metaphors use हुए हैं वो discuss कर लेते हैं. Metaphors जो हैं वो इसमें you can say their future painted with fog. Yes, their future painted with fog. यहाँ पर क्या है? Metaphor है. And how we can describe metaphor? It refers to the future of slum children, which has been compared to fog because it is uncertain and unclear, right? Similarly, sealed in with the lead sky, it describes that dull and grey color of the sky and also depressing future of the slum children, right?